Hello, my name is Keshwani. That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I, Keshwani. We are here because we want to learn how to solve algebra word problems. Today we'll do solve problem number 198. Problem, as you can see, is already on the blackboard. Let's take a look at it, shall we? It says, 5 years ago, Kathy was half as old as her brother Adam. 4 years from now, we are told, she will be 4/5 of the age. It says 4/5 twice. And she will be 4/5 the age of her other brother Billy. Apparently, she has two brothers, Adam and Billy. We are further told that the total today, the sum of her and her brother's ages is 30. Question simply is, how old are they now? As we can clearly see, we have three actors in here: Adam, Billy, and the sister Kathy. And to find their ages, to find these three unknowns, we need to have three equations. That's the only way we're going to be able to find the value of three variables. If we have three, simply saying the three equations is not enough. Three independent equations. And we do have three independent equations. Three independent equations are staring right in our face here. These three sentences are the three equations. So let's start out with something simple, the most basic, straightforward, which is the sum. Their sum is 30. So that's going to be very straightforward, the first equation. Where can we put it there? Let's start out here. This is the first equation. Let's first define our variable. Here's the solution. It's very important that you define your variable. Let A be Adam's present age. Simply saying let A be Adam's age. And let B be Billy's age, and so on and so forth, will not be enough here. This is not enough. This is not clear. This is not straightforward. This is not correct, because we are dealing with three different time periods. We are dealing with more than one time periods. And since we are dealing with more than one time periods, simply saying let A be Adam's age is not sufficient. We have to say let A represent Adam's present age. We could let A represent Adam's age 5 years ago, or we could have used A to represent Adam's years 4 years from now, but it will be more straightforward to use A to represent his present age. Similarly, B will represent Billy's present age. And C, let C represent Kathy's present age. Now that the variables are defined, A, B, and C represents their present ages, we know that the sum of their ages, A plus B plus C, would have to be 30. Because it comes from right here. It says today, the sum of their ages is 30. Let's call this equation 1. We'll leave this at the bottom. Now let's work on equation 2 and equation 3 from the first and the second sentences on the top here. 5 years ago and 4 years from now. Keep that in mind. We're dealing with two different time periods, 5 years ago and 4 years from now. We need the room, so we're going to erase all of this stuff. So here we have Adam, here we have Billy, and here we have sister Kathy. 5 years ago, and 4 years from now. 4 years from now. Well, if A represents Adam's present age, then 5 years ago, whatever his age is today, if he's 12 years old today, 5 years ago he must have been 12 minus 5. And hence, his age 5 years ago was A minus 5. Similarly, if B represents Billy's present age, 5 years ago he must have been whatever his age is today, minus 5 years. And if C represents Kathy's present age, then 5 years ago she must have been whatever she is today. If she is 35 years old today, then 5 years ago she must have been 35 minus 5, or 30 years old. 4 years from now, whatever Adam is today, Adam is 8 years old today, so 4 years from now he will be whatever his age is today, plus 4 more years. whatever Billy's age is today, 4 years from now, is going to be plus 4. And similarly, Kathy will be C plus 4. That's it. Now, take care of our equations. So this equation at the bottom that you see there, is always there. We're not going to worry about it. Let's read the question one more time. It says, 5 years ago, Kathy was half as old as her brother, Adam. So here's Kathy. 5 years ago, Kathy was C minus 5, and Adam, she's talking about. 5 years ago, Kathy was half as old as her brother, Adam. Adam was A minus 5. There we go. Is it correct? No, this is not correct. What does this equation say? This equation says that 5 years ago, Kathy was just as old as her brother, Adam. That's not the case. We're not told that she was just as old as her brother Adam. We are told that 5 years ago she was half as old. So whatever Adam's age is, whatever Adam's age was 5 years ago, which is A minus 5, if you were to take half of that amount, that's how Kathy was. That's how old Kathy was. Kathy was, see, 5 years ago. 5 years ago, Kathy was half as old as her brother Adam. Adam was A minus 5. If you take half that amount, that's how old she was. Now let's work on 4 years from now. 4 years from now, we are told she'll be 450 age of her other brother, Billy. Her other brother, Billy, is going to be 4 plus B plus 4. And Kathy is going to be C plus 4. Is this correct? Answer again is no. Answer is this is not correct, because what this equation says is that Kathy, 4 years from now, she's going to be just as old as her brother, Billy, 4 years from now. That is not the case. This is not correct. We are told that 4 years from now, she will be 450 age. 4/5 of Billy's age. Whatever the Billy's age is going to be, which is B plus 4, she's going to be 4/5 that amount. Follow. Now we can work on it, shall we? Let's work on it. And of course, this is our first equation. Don't forget it. I'm going to erase it, but remember, we have this first equation, which was the sum of their ages 30. Don't forget that part. And that's the equation we're going to use at the end. Here we can substitute, we can solve for A, this we can equate, okay, watch, we can solve this equation, we can solve this equation for A in terms of C, we can solve this equation, B, at least we can solve this equation for B in terms of C. Once we have solved B in terms of C, and once we have the value of A in terms of C, we're going to substitute that in equation number 1, which is A plus B plus C equals 30. And we're going to solve for C. Why don't you do it yourself? Do it yourself if you like. The work is almost done. I forgot to ask you to pause the video in the beginning. I should have asked you to do it yourself in the beginning, but you can pick up from here. Pause the video and do it yourself if you like. Here we go. Let's solve for A. So if you're going to solve for A, multiply both sides by 2. If you multiply both sides by 2, the 2 is going to drop out, and we end up with 2 times C, 2C minus 10 equals A minus 5. A minus 5. Add 5 to both sides, and we'll find that A equals 2C minus 5. 2C minus 5. Minus 10, negative 10, and positive 5 is going to give us negative 5. That's the first equation there. A equals 2C minus 5. Let's solve this equation for B. Multiply both sides by 5. We end up with 5 times C plus 4 equals 4 times B plus 4. Multiply it out. We get 5C plus 20 equals 4b plus 16. Remember, we are solving for b. So bring the 16 to this side, bring 16 to subtract 16 from both sides, and 4b equals 5c. 20 minus 16 is going to be 4, and b is going to be just a fourth of that. If you divide both sides by 4, this is how old b is. There you go. We have B in terms of C. We have A in terms of C. Let's put it in the first equation. Our first equation simply told us that sum of their ages was 30. A plus B plus C has to equal 30. A we know is 2C minus 5. 2C minus 5. B we know is this amount right here. 5c plus 4 over 4, and c of course is c plus 30. Let's get rid of this 4 from the bottom. Let's multiply the entire equation by 4. you multiply entire equation by 4, this multiply this term by 4, multiply this, let's do it in a different color. Multiply first term by 4, multiply the second term by 4, and multiply this guy by 4. This 4 is going to drop out, and you have to multiply this side by 4. The entire equation has to be multiplied by 4. And we got rid of our denominator. So now we have to go 4 times 2c, which is going to be 8c. 4 times negative 5 is going to be negative 20. Let's put it here. Plus this quantity right here, 5c plus 4 plus 4c. Plus 4c has to equal 120. We are running out of room, so we're going to erase this part now. Four c plus five c is going to be 13c. 13c plus 4c is going to be 17c. 17c would have to equal 120 plus 20. 120 plus 20. If you bring this 20 to the other side, and a minus 4. So that's simply 120 plus 16. 120 plus 16 would be 136. So how many 17 do you suppose is going to be 136, assuming that c is a whole number, which I'm going to assume right now for the time being to see if it works out or not. If it doesn't work out, then we'll think about something else. So let's see if it works out that c is actually a whole number. How do we find out if c is going to be actually a whole number or not? Here's the trick. You see, what you have to understand is that if you were to multiply 17, this 17 here, by any number, if you multiply it by 1, it's going to end in a 1, end in a 7. If you multiply it by 2, it's going to end in a 4, and so on and so forth. We're looking for multiples of 7. This one does not play any role. Multiples of 7. Multiples of 7, is it possible for it to end in a 6? Of course it's possible. Of course it's possible. 7 ones are 7, 7 2s are 14, 21, 28, 35. That represents 7, 5, 7, 6 are going to be 42, and 49, and 56. There you go, voila. This is the table of 7 with the unit digit. We are only interested in unit digit. 7 eighths. 7 eighths are 56. How do we know that? Because 7 sevens are 49. 7 sevens are 49. If 7 sevens are 49, it should say 7 seven, not 7 nines. If 7 sevens are 49, then 7 eighths are 56, which tells me that I should try 8 first. We should try 8, see if it works out. And if it doesn't work out, then we'll worry about c being something other than an integer. But in most cases, they're integers. What do you suppose 17 times 8 is? 7 eighths are 56, we already know that. 6, carry 5. 8 plus 5 is 13, what do you know? It is exactly 8 times. It is exactly 8 times. So that tells us, this implies that c was 8 years old. That's it, we are done. Once we know the value of c, we can figure out a and b. That's all we want to find out. So now let's do the a. A is right here, 2c minus 5. A equals 2c minus 5. We can figure out c is equal to 2, or c is equal to 8. So it's 2 times 8, which is 16 minus 5, which is going to be 11 years old. And b is right there, 5c plus 4 over 4. 5c plus 4 over 4, 5 times c, which is 8, 8 5s are 40, 40 plus 4 over 4, 40 plus 4 is 44, so it's 44 over 4 is 11, oh, what do you know? It turns out that b is also 11, a turns out to be 11, and it turns out in this problem that b also is 11, Billy is also 11. Billy is also 11. Adam is 11 and Billy is 11. How is that possible? There are only two possible explanations where this will be true. One is that they happen to be twins, or perhaps they have different mothers and therefore they are the same age, born in the same year. There we go. Adam and Billy. We have to quickly verify, make sure that it works out. The sum of their ages has to be 30, which it does. 11 plus 11 is 22. 22 plus 8 is 30. It works out. See you tomorrow, okay? Bye now.